All right, what's going on, everybody? It's Jay Myrex, aka F Major, and I'm back. I just want to talk to you guys today because I'm actually in the middle of tracking out a beat, and I decided, hey, this is probably a good time to maybe discuss one of these ideas that I had. Actually, I'm getting a lot of questions about how to track out music inside a machine, especially when using Maschine as a sound module in Logic. So I thought maybe I should take a step back and maybe explain a bit about how I'm working with Maschine, at least, because I'll definitely do a video on tracking out things in Logic, but maybe just to give you a little bit of inspiration or some insight into how I'm working, I'll just take this time now to let you guys know. Basically, when I use Maschine, I actually try to use Maschine and stand alone as far as I can possibly get. I try to do, you know, as many different patterns and sequences in there as I can, because first of all, I got Maschine because it's a simplified tactile workflow. It allows me to make music with my ears primarily and not have to focus on the screen so much. So I definitely prefer to use Maschine for the initial writing process. I use it as a VST host, and I put all my software instruments in there and try to get as much going as possible. I use it as a sketch pad, and then I do the rest of my arrangement and production basically inside of a DAW. So what happens is, when I make my music inside a machine, once I get all my patterns and my scenes together, I export audio stems. And the reason I do it that way instead of using drag and drop is because it's just simpler to use the export audio function inside a machine, because it allows you to export the entire stems for the entire duration of the track instead of having to drag and drop per scene or per pattern. So it's very easy for me to track out things offline, so I don't have to sit up and listen to it, because that was one of the main reason I actually got Maschine too, was because I knew that it had an offline bouncing method. So instead of doing real-time tracking with like the MPC, for example, I could just tell it to bounce all my drums as stems for the entire length of the track, and I could put those in my DAW for mixing purposes. So I typically use the integrating Logic with Maschine or Maschine with Logic method when I'm adding additional parts to an arrangement. So say I have all my stems inside of Logic. What I'll do is, say if I want to make another transition, or I want to build up a section of my song or just create a change up, I may then pull Maschine in as a sound module so that I can write additional parts to my arrangement inside of Logic. But that's already what I'm dealing with, primarily audio from Maschine anyhow. I typically try not to do too much writing with Maschine as a sound module, because it takes away from the tracking out process, in my opinion. What happens is, when you start to write in Logic using Maschine as a sound module, you have to use Logic to bounce the audio. And for me, the best way I found to do that is to use the function inside of Logic that splits MIDI regions into MIDI pitches, and that way I can get separate pitches for the drums. For example, the drums would have to be separate pitches anyhow, so what it does is creates an individual track for each drum sound, and then I use bounce in place in order to turn each of those MIDI tracks into an individual stem or audio file. Equally, if I'm using like a Maschine sound or instrument, for example, then I don't split those. I actually just bounce in place the track for that, and that makes it a lot easier. But at the same time, I wouldn't prefer to do that for my entire track. And simply since I don't write in logic solely anyhow, it just makes more sense for me to just bounce or export audio from Maschine and do the final arrangements inside of Logic. I also mix inside of the DAW anyhow. So for me, trying to approach Maschine as this all-in-one thing has never been my intention. And I actually see a lot of people asking me about how to mix inside a Maschine or how to mix inside, how to split the audio from Maschine. So for me, it's important to realize you need to get the audio out of Maschine. You don't want to mix inside a Maschine because there's three different levels of gain staging inside a Maschine that you have to consider as you're working. And it's, for me at least, it's much easier to just consider the channel volume and master volume inside of my DAW instead of having to worry about sound volume, then group volume, and then master volume inside a Maschine. So yeah, I don't use drag and drop audio. That's just not the way I work because it's a bit too much effort for what I'm trying to accomplish. All I want to do is export full stems for the duration of the track that I've developed inside a Maschine, and then use my DAW to get my levels, my mix, and the rest of my arrangement together. So that's just how I work. Everybody's going to be different. So, you know, if you have questions, feel free to ask me. I'll probably still have to do a video regarding the whole process of splitting audio or splitting the MIDI notes and creating MIDI tracks in Logic so that you can understand how I'm using the bounce in place in Logic, because that is a little bit complicated at first, but once you get the hang of it, it's pretty simple and straightforward. But I'll work on that video as well, because that's probably going to be easier to see visually than just to have someone talking about it. All right, but hopefully I got you thinking a bit, and maybe you'll explore on your own and find a way that works best for you. All right, I'll holler at y'all later. Peace and God bless.